Hi, I'm Deena Kadija. I study molecular genetics at King's College London, and this is Lepas Sekolah.
So Deena, what did you want to be when you were growing up?
I've always wanted to do designer babies. I like the idea that you could gene edit and then just like change the color, the eye color of a baby, or like the hair color, whatever you want.
And who was your biggest inspiration growing up?
My biggest inspiration? This is like unrelated to genetics, but my biggest inspiration would be Greta Gerwig. So she's a film director. It's because in a lot of her films, she explores the theme of identity and girlhood, which are themes that I really resonate with.
And where did you go to secondary school?
I went to MRSM Kuantan.
So what subjects did you do for SPM?
For SPM, I took the science stream. So that means I did chemistry, biology, and physics.
And why did you decide to do those subjects?
I wasn't into accounting, but also I just have a genuine interest in biology specifically because I like to know how the human body works.
And how did you do for SPM?
I got 9 A's for my SPM.
What are your study tips for SPM?
Have a sustainable schedule. Don't just like cramp your study. I think have a proper break, do sports, hang out with your friends while still study. Just have a balanced schedule, I think.
And what do you say for those sitting for their SPM papers right now?
Please take it seriously. I know like some people say if you don't do well, it's not the end of the world. But it does feel like it's the end of the world for me when I was sitting. I think just do your best.
So Deena, do you receive a scholarship after SPM?
I do have a convertible loan with MARA.
And what does that mean?
It means that you're not bonded, but you have to pay a certain amount back to MARA. And that depends on your grades. So if, for example, if you get a first class, then you only have to pay like 10-15%. So then like for second upper, you would have to pay like 15%, and then second lower would be like 25%. So it increased by 5%.
Where did you go for pre-university and why?
I did my pre-U at Kolej MARA Banting. I did IB, the International Baccalaureate.
And how is that structured? And so, how is it different from other, you know, pre-university courses?
If I were to compare it to like A-levels, IB was supposed to be like a more holistic education. I had to take 6 different subjects. I did biology, chemistry, English, maths, econs, and Malay. And then there's 3 additional components to it. So extended essay, which is a 4,000 words essay on any topic you like. Theory of knowledge, it's basically a subject about how you know what you know. And then there's the extracurricular parts of it, like CAS.
And yep. What's CAS? Can you elaborate?
Okay. CAS is basically creativity, action, and service. So you have to like pass it to pass IB as a whole. So if you got like full points and you fail CAS, then you fail IB. So it's very important. And for CAS, what I did was I did like voluntary work with my group to like refurbish our sports center in KMB. So that's also like part of CAS.
And how did you do for IB?
I got 41 out of 45, so that's like an average, like averaging an A.
Okay, so what's your fondest memory in KMB?
I'd say like friends and the teachers. I know this is cliche, but like in a very rigorous education syllabus like IB, I think that was like really important, and that what makes it bearable and manageable when I was doing IB.
Why do you say it's rigorous?
Why do I say it's rigorous? Okay, I think it's like the workload of IB. It's just like a lot. So it's not just exams. It's 70% exams and then 30% coursework. So for 6 subjects that you took, each of those subjects, you have to write a paper on the subject, except for the languages, which you only have like oral. On top of that, the 4,000 word essay I talk about. And for theory of knowledge, you also have to write an essay. There's a lot of coursework on top of like the exams that you have to sit in May.
What do you advise for someone looking to make the best of their time in KMB?
I would say like get a really good support system, because the education is like rigorous, but you also have to think that you have UCAS applications, and then if you're going to the GS, that's even like more work. So it's very important like to keep you sane. It's very important to have like a very good support system.
And for someone who's not used to having one, what is a support system?
What that means would just be have like friends that you could rely on in terms of like keeping you accountable, like always showing up for study. Also have friends to like check and like proofread your applications, proofread your essays and all that.
How did you prepare for the scholarship application process, just to circle back?
It was pretty simple. Like for Mara specifically, like fill in the form after you got your results, and then there's an interview. So what I did was just like practicing interview questions. I asked my seniors around like what sort of questions they would usually ask, and it's usually just like interview 101.
So molecular genetics at King's, what does that mean? What do you study?
I study gene mutations. So I study what's wrong with your gene and how that would lead to diseases.
What inspired you to do molecular genetics at King's?
I think it's the idea of like the designer babies that I talked about.
So your final year, which means you're going to be graduating this summer. How are you feeling about that?
I'm pretty happy that I'm graduating. I enjoy studying though. But I do feel like I need like growth outside of just studying, like putting pen to paper. Mm.
This also means you'll be job hunting, right? How's that going?
Currently, I'm still doing like assessments and like waiting for job offers. So that nothing is like set in stone yet.
How's that going so far? How are you feeling about it?
I mean, I guess like if you asked me like a week ago, I'm very, very overwhelmed. Only because a lot of things are happening at once. I have a lab report to submit. I am studying for exams. I am still in the middle of like job applications. So it was just like really overwhelming and a very difficult time for me.
Are you considering staying in the UK? And if so, what factors are you considering?
I did consider like staying in the UK. I no longer consider that since I got rejected from like all the UK jobs I applied to. So I guess like having a job is a big factor. I mean like the alternative to that is applying for a graduate visa. But I'm not exactly considering doing a graduate visa, only because the current job market in the UK is not exactly ideal. So you might finish the 2 years of your graduate visa not getting a job anyway. So
this job market situation, is it just STEM jobs in general or just the job market in general? You know?
Obviously, in the UK, there is a lot more like space, but again, it's very like very competitive. London is overpopulated. But I guess like from what I see from my business friends, it seems like it's also like pretty tough for them as well.
So what was your favorite module at King's and why?
I would say my epigenetics module. So what epigenetics is, it's basically studying how environmental factors would affect how your gene works. And why I like that module, I think it's because when I first registered for that module, I thought it's a pseudoscience. It kind of sounds like a pseudoscience. But what I found out is that it's very like data heavy and it's very empirical. And I guess like my lecturer was very good. It was a very challenging module, so I kind of like it. I think I was given a gene that's not very well researched with asthma. So then what I have to do is basically I have to research on the gene myself, finding like connecting the dots between what the gene does, what's the signaling pathway, and how does the signaling pathway would affect asthma.
Did you have to do any interesting lab work?
Well, like obviously, most of my lab work would be gene editing. The most interesting one was probably when I had to do like CRISPR-Cas9 on bacteria. We're trying to utilize the bacterial system and grow human hormone from the bacteria using CRISPR-Cas9.
Do you regret your STEM degree?
I really enjoyed my degree. Towards the end of my degree, like, I realized that I really enjoyed studying it. But I, in terms of like work, like getting a job, I do wish like I did a more slightly easier degree, I guess. I don't necessarily think that I have the personality to work in STEM. I can do it, but I don't think I have the personality for it. So now I'm jumping into corporate. So then like, I guess when you do corporate job applications, it doesn't really matter. Like, my degree doesn't really matter because it's quant, but I could have done like a slightly easier quant degree.
Pivoting away from job searching and academics, how has your university life been so far?
I think it's been like pretty fun. It's very transformative, I'd say. I joined a lot of like student societies. I joined UKC, I joined Kalsom, but like outside of like the Malaysian student organizations, I joined like Film Society. What else did I join? There's a few. One realization I had about student societies in the UK, like the culture is very different than the ones in Malaysia. I'd say like the student societies in the UK at least like the serious one, so like King's Business Club or like King's Quant Society, those are like societies that are very important if you actually do want to land a job in London, especially because the function of this society is actually they help you network with like corporate, and also just like help you with CVs, help you with like job applications, help you with like consulting workshops even.
I understand student societies have been a big part of your university life and extracurriculars. How does it impact you?
I guess it's correct, the building. I learned a lot. I learned a lot from UKC, I'm not gonna lie. But then that it gives me like opportunities that I think I wouldn't have gotten like in Malaysia. My film society does a lot of interviews, like talks with notable people in Hollywood. So we had Sean Baker. I think he's like editor director for like Anora, so the Oscar Best Picture.
With graduation and job hunting and everything, how has this entire transition process made you feel so far?
I guess the transition is difficult. So I was overwhelmed, I crashed out. Especially when like everything is happening at once. Because I guess first and second year was fine. And then when you get to like final year, suddenly you have to think about jobs. You have to think about whether, like, if you're not bonded, then you have to think about whether you want to stay in the UK or like go back to Malaysia. You have to think about your studies. Now your exams matters a lot more.
What's your advice for someone looking to make the most of their time in King's?
If you know your passion, I think like explore them. Actually join the societies, make a lot of friends. But also, I know like people say studying is not everything, but I do feel like if you actually go to your lectures, take your academic seriously, I'm pretty sure there's a lot of transferable skills that actually matters in your job application.
Could you summarize your journey lepas sekolah in 3 weeks?
It's soul stirring, chaotic adventure. My name is Deena, and this is my journey lepas sekolah.